parseDate function is used to parse a date string or date text value into a date value. So basically, it means that we have a date value, but in Looker Studio, it just recognizes it as text or a text string. So you have to do something which is parsing this date into an actual date value that's being recognized by Looker Studio in order to use all the special features available for date field. So with that in mind, let's look at the syntax of parseDate function. The syntax is parse underscore date. In the parentheses, specify the format string, which is the format of the date string, then followed by the date text, which is the string value that you want to parse. Next, I'll guide you on how to use the parseDate function in Looker Studio. First of all, let's create a sample date field using calculated field. You can choose any of the data set here, but for the sake of organization, I'm going to use data set 2, which is where we created the first formula of this chapter. So now scroll down and find the add a field button and click on it. Let's call this as sample text date. Then we're going to give it a value, the single quote 2023-01-01. Make sure the values is in the single quote, or you can also use the double quote if you want. They are interchangeably here. Now I'm going to stick to this and click save and finish. This new calculated field is going to give us a date value in text data type. So you can see that on the corner of this calculated field, when I'm not hovering it, it's showing ABC, which means it's a text as compared to other date field that you will see a calendar icon next to it. Now that we have prepared a date in text, next we want to apply the parseDate formula to convert this text into date. Now let's add another calculated field. Let's name it as 2.4.2 parseDate. Then we're going to enter the formula parseDate, followed by parentheses, and inside the parentheses, you're going to specify the date string that you want to parse. So this is going to refer to the format of the current date that we have created in a text format. So if you recall, it is %y, which indicates we have 4-digit year, and dash, percent, followed by a small letter m. This refers to 2-digit of the month number, followed by a dash, %d. This refers to 2-digit of the day number. Now that we have done with the format string, next we are going to indicate the text field, which we have created just now. You can straight away click from this available fields tab to add the field, or you can feel free to type it out if you want. Now that we have done with the formula, click save and finish. We're going to add a table chart to see the values. Once you have added a table, make sure to change it to dataset 2 or whichever dataset that you created the field in. For me, it's dataset 2, and I'm going to add the sample text. And I'm going to add the new field that I created with the parseDate formula just now. One thing you will notice is that this parseDate calculated field has a calendar icon next to it. That means that we have converted it to date data type. Let's also get rid of the mantra because it's not related. Now in this table, you can see that this is the original value, which is in text. On the right hand side for the new calculated field, you will see that the date is displayed in the default format used by Looker Studio to display a date data type. So what I've shown here is just an example of one single use case. There are actually more use cases that you can use for the parseDate function depending on the date format in text or any other data type. We will need to indicate the corresponding format string in order for Looker Studio to correctly parse it into a date or date time. Next, I'm going to go through this reference table with you so you know where to find the correct format string. So first, you will need to check if your date value is in text or number. If your date is in text data type, look at the first table, which is this one. You can see different formats here on the left. And the right side, you will see the formula that you can use to parse it into a date field in Looker Studio. So for example, with the first format, which is what we have covered just now in the lab session, this is the format that you are going to use. You will notice this date format string is the same as what we have used earlier in the lab. Let's take another example. Let's say the delimiter is in slash and not in dash. You will just have to change the dash into slash in this format string. If there's no delimiter, then you'll have to indicate it without the delimiter as well. So that's how you can modify the format string to cater for different formats that you will need in the reporting. However, if your date is in number format, you will need to cast the field as text first before you can apply the parse date formula. So I'm going to go to the lab session and show you how to do that. First of all, we are going to create a new calculated field. Add a field and let's call it sample number date. In the formula, let's key in 2023-0101. Click save and finish. Now you see this new field here, and at the left hand side, you can see the icon 123. This means that this is a number data type. Then we're going to click to add another field. Now we're going to key in 2.4.1 parse date, and this is for number. Now, first of all, before we enter the parse date formula, since our sample date is in number format, we will need to cast it into a text first. So we're going to type the cast formula first, followed by a parenthesis. Then we're going to enter the sample date, which is in number format. So I'll just click on this instead of typing it out. Then followed by S. Next, we're going to indicate the data type that we want to cast this into, which is text. Next, we are going to convert this text into a date. But before we do that, we are going to take a look at what is the exact format of this sample date after it's being cast into text, because that is going to be very helpful later when you are trying to figure out the format string. So let's click save and finish. And I'm going to make a copy of this table. Now in the data tab, we're going to add sample number date 2.4, the one with the number. Now we can see that there's no changes in the format of the string after we have converted it into a text. So now we can continue with the formula. All right, and now let's do the parse date formula followed by percent capital letter Y, percent small letter M, percent small letter D. This is almost the same format string that we used in the previous lab example, but we are just removing the dash here because there's no dash in this format. So now close the bracket and I'm going to click update and finish. Now you can see right away that this has changed into a date format, and that means we have successfully accomplished the task today. That's all for today. If you have any questions, feel free to post it in our community page and I'll get back to you as soon as possible. Thank you so much, and I'll see you in the next one. Bye bye.